Welcome back to The Truth with Trinity, and I am your host, Trinity, and if this is your first time tuning into the podcast, I'd like to send you a warm welcome. Here I talk about issues that happen within the Black community, hopefully for some resolution or at least some food for thought to go about your daily way. So without further ado, I'd like to jump into this episode's topic, which is, does the Black man use the Black woman as his crutch for failure? So I want to start off with saying, you know, I have never seen so many men that want respect and demand respect blame their women so much for their downfalls in life. You know, I've never seen any other group of men do that so much so than a Black man. And I also want to make a small disclaimer, you know, this does not apply to all Black men, but you know, it would be a disservice not to mention those that this topic does apply to. I wanted to start off by saying, you know, that many guys say that they want a woman with old school values. But a lot of these guys that want these women with old school values, they lack these principles themselves. You know, as you watch the videos on social media, once again, YouTube, Facebook, you know, even if you talk to guys, you know, individually in your own cities, you know, they'll say they want a woman that's loyal. They want a woman that's faithful. You know, they want a woman that's considerate, that's not selfish. But a lot of these guys, they're lacking these principles themselves. They're not loyal. They're not faithful. A lot of them have become lovers of themselves. You know, and I think quite honestly, it's caused the domino effect on the Black woman. Now the Black woman's becoming more selfish than ever, and she's not caring about the needs of, you know, her men, basically. And another thing that's going on is there are many interviews with other Black men about their displeasure in Black women. But I don't see too many videos on how Black men can do better. So there's thousands of videos, you know, and streams that are talking about, you know, how Black women are this and Black women are that and the negative things about Black women. And you mainly see a lot of Black men taking a victimhood stance. You know, they're not only taking a victimhood stance with, you know, discussing Black women and their problems with Black women, but even in this world, even in America, even, you know, with their police dealings and their jobs and their financial situations, you know, I believe the Black man has been too comfortable for too long just taking a stance of just being the poor wounded victim. And most of our Black men, their growth mentally has been stunted, you know. So, you know, on the outside, they look like grown men, strong, tall, or whatever. You know, they look basically mustache. You know, they look grown on the outside, but their mentality is stunted, a lot of them. They never transition from being a boy to a man. And I believe sometimes it's because their mothers have spoiled them too much. You know, sometimes, and a lot of times, a lot of our Black men, they're coming from single mother homes. And, you know, it's always been an argument in our communities that, you know, there'll be a Black woman that says, hey, I raised my son to be a lawyer. I was a single mother. But what Black people need to start doing is look at the statistics on the success rate on single parents raising successful children, in particular Black men. Yes, it can be done. He can end up a doctor or a surgeon. So we all know those type of stories. But what happens is when a man is growing up in the home and see a woman and they don't see a man, there's already a chemical, psychological imbalance anyway. So he's seeing a woman, you know, around the home acting like a woman, you know, her menstrual cycle. Oh, I can't move. You know, it's raining outside. My arthritis is hurting. You know, so things that women complain about a lot. And so when a man grows up in that type of environment, they got that gimme type of mentality. So they've seen their mother, you know, it's too much snow on the ground. You know, so a mother might say it's too much snow on the ground. I'm not going to work or something. So then you get these men growing up. Oh, it's too cold to go to work. So you get a lot of these men growing up with female tendencies because that's all they've ever seen growing up, even if it's, you know, even if they're not aware of it. Another thing is, you know, a lot of times, you know, when a child grows up in a single parent home, you know, sometimes the mothers, they may try to overcompensate, you know, give them extra toys and more clothes. And this is a way of a mother, you know, knowing that the father may not be around, but she's saying in her head as a mother, hey, I'm giving my child everything that I can. So the extra PlayStations, the extra, you know, bedroom sets and everything like that, you know, the extra covers and comforters. But what ends up happening, especially with our young Black men, is they get everything handed to them. Okay. So they're being treated like the spoiled little girl in the house, but it's the mother. So look at that role transition right there. So this is not daddy's little girl. It's mommy's little boy being treated like daddy's little girl. Okay. So a lot of these young brothers are growing up getting money, extras. They're getting everything from their mothers. So what it's doing is that's killing their drive to earn for a living. And so, with a lot of these Black men growing up from single parent households, okay, so their mothers are spoiling them and things of that nature. And even if it's not necessarily spoiling them, they're not gaining the necessary skills needed to become a man. Okay. So when they get out here and they get with the next woman, okay, they're so used to just coming inside of a woman's house, entering into her house, putting up his feet and saying, hey, I'm king of the castle. You're going to go to work as a woman. You're going to do this. And I'm going to sit right here, because they're so used to their mother being that man in the house. Okay. So their minds are all messed up. And so that just is a recipe for disaster for a lot of our Black men to start off with. Okay. As an adolescent, a lot of young Black men were never taught any useful skills that would benefit themselves, a career, or a woman. So basically, you know, a lot of our Black men growing up, you know, because of the single parent homes, or even, you know, even if they grew up in the house with a father, some of them, the father may not have taken time or known themselves to teach them skills on how to be useful, not only for a career or a woman, but for himself. So these are skills like HVAC, plumbing, drywall, building houses, mechanics, carpentry, things that will make you useful in a woman's eyes, okay? Something that you can create a revenue of money for yourself. Something you can be proud of yourself. You know, a man is a creator, you know, and a lot of these young men, they don't have that. They don't have that. And I think a lot of Black men are saying, you know, the Black woman goes out of her way to make it seem like the Black man is not useful in the household, when the reality is a lot of Black men are bringing nothing but sex to the table themselves, okay? And they're not sure of what to do outside of the bedroom other than sex, okay? And we're going to talk about that a little bit more in just a second, okay? And another thing that usually happens, you know, when a lot of, you know, Black men are not getting their education, you know, they may be sitting at their mother's houses, they may be playing the video game, or they may be out in the streets and they come home. A lot of our young black men, they're not transitioning to their own houses. They're transitioning from their mother's house to another woman's house. So they're never learning any skills on how to be truly independent, okay? They're transitioning from their mother's house to another woman's house and then back to their mother's house again, okay? Which can leave some Black men feeling upset and left behind, because while the average Black man, you know, he's bouncing back and forth between a woman to his mother's house to another woman's house, you know, these Black women are being left with the children, you know, as so many Black men have openly said. And there's no excuse for the Black man at this day and age, because if so many Black women can have financial aid, just like a Black man can have financial aid, he can take himself to school as well. Okay, he can take himself right on to school. And a lot of times they don't have the children hanging off of them because they've left them with the child's mother, with their child's mother. So, you know, the only thing that's stopping most Black men is having a criminal record. And that's why it's so important to teach the young Black male not to get a criminal record. It's not cool. It's not fun. It's not attractive. It's none of that. It's going to ruin your life, because that will enable you to have a tool to have when you have a clean criminal record, to be able to go on and make something of yourself, so that you're not sitting somewhere being upset, being mad, or feeling like you need to abuse another Black woman because you feel like she thinks that she's something better than you are because you don't have any education. And then she's sitting with the education, because that makes such an imbalance in the home anyway when two people get together. Let me continue. Like I said, it leaves a lot of Black men, you know, feeling left behind, you know, when they try to date a woman that may have skills and education and they haven't gained any, or even, you know, graduated from high school. If they date a woman with education, they feel intimidated. And I find with a lot of these guys, you know, they don't want to date a woman that, you know, hasn't graduated from high school. They love, you know, these type of guys love the pick of the pick. You know, because sometimes, I guess somewhere in their head, they feel like they deserve the best. So they don't want to get with Bukisha, who may not have graduated from school herself. He wants to get with the one that's, you know, got the master's, got the, you know, bachelor's degree, you know, the nurses and things of that nature, the lawyers, you know, for some reason. And like I said, they tend to feel intimidated. And a lot of times what happened is they may try and sabotage her career. Out of instinct of needing to feel like the alpha male or lead, you know. So sometimes, you know, I think some of these guys may actually love these women, okay, that they may deal with, but it's just hurtful to see him, you know, in the mirror, to look at himself in the mirror, knowing that he's dealing with a woman that may be more educated. And, you know, some of these guys will say, it's a Black woman, she's pushing her degrees in my face, when the reality is there are a numerous amount of Black women that, you know, have tried to hide their light up under a bushel, so to speak, tried to make the man feel like the man of the house, not being boastful or braggadocious about her hourly earnings or any of that. And the man still turns around and tries to belittle her in the house, because it's just something inside that doesn't feel right within itself, when he has to look in the mirror and knowing that he could be doing better. So I really don't think it's an issue as far as Black women bragging so much about their education as much as it is the Black man looking himself in the mirror, knowing that he's dealing with someone that he really cannot really financially, or it's not even so much financially, but just this woman that he's trying to obtain is out of his league, basically. And it's something he's feeling inside of himself when he looks in the mirror, to know that he could have done better and he can do better if he would just get off the couch and just go out here and make it happen the same way the Black woman did. So it's like, well, if the Black woman can make it happen, you know, why can't, you know, he get out there and make it happen? Okay. Another thing is too, a lot of the brothers, they may seek women outside of the relationship more so than the average man to overcompensate for his shortcomings. Okay, so I'm going to repeat that again. You know, like I said, a lot of women, you know, of different races and stuff, they complain that, you know, every now and then their man may have done this or that. But it seems like with the Black man, he seeks women outside of the relationship more so than the average man. Because I believe this is one of the ways that, you know, Black men have been taught to see themselves as men, as macho, you know, as many women, you know, if they have 10 or 12 women, you know, you see it, you know, in the videos and stuff, like I said, of a man, you know, feeling like this is his way of being a man. So it's not to educate themselves. It's not to go on and, you know, see if he can, you know, get a loan for this business. You know, they're not doing that. A lot of the young Black men, especially, they are seeking it through multiple women, which is the wrong way to do it. And then they wonder why, you know, they have so many babies by so many different women. And a lot of times they'll do it too. And this isn't just Black men, but some men do this, period. You know, especially if they're dealing with a woman that is, you know, very successful, they will push other women in their wife's face or a woman's face just to make them feel low self-esteemed. Okay, so, you know, if you're, you know, so if a guy is dealing with a woman or he's married to a woman, you know, and she's not pushing it up in his face that she's successful, but she just happens to be, you know, have a master's degree or a PhD or something. And, you know, he doesn't really have a job, or, you know, his job is, you know, just a skilled job that's not, you know, paying anywhere near as much as hers is paying, but she's trying to make him feel like a man. She's trying to, you know, she's trying to pamper him, and something inside of him feels missing. Some guys will actually just bring women up in that woman's face just to for her to know her place or something, for her to you know, feel bad about herself, for her to question herself. Okay, so this is his way of making himself feel like a man. Some men do this, not all men, but some, you know, some of our brothers are doing that. Especially, like, you know, especially for sisters that let, you know, men borrow their car while they're at work or something. You know, it's like he doesn't have his own car. You know, that's that mother-son complex again, you know. So you're handing him your car, for him to go sleep with someone else while you're hard at work, and he's supposed to be at home. Okay, so here's a couple ways that I think, you know, guys, especially some black men, you know, when you talk to them, you know, especially if they're, I hate to say this, but the loser type, may try to sell themselves to a woman, is they may talk about how good they are in bed, okay, but are clueless outside the bedroom. So, you know, if you're first talking to a guy and they start talking about, and they start talking about how good they are and how good they can make you feel in bed and what type of massages they can do, okay? And a lot of these brothers, I find that they know exactly what to do in the bedroom, but they are clueless, anything outside the bedroom about their relationships with women. So what they know about women stops the minute you get out the bed with them. And I feel like that's a problem with a lot of black men, because they don't study the art of relationships. They're more concerned about sex versus having an honest, committed relationship. Another thing is, some of them will brag about how good of a cook they are or how well they clean. So this is the Mr. Mom complex, you know. You know, so their qualifications are how good they are in bed and how well they can run a bath, a bubble bath for you. And it's like, no, that sounds like qualifications of a wife more so than a man. And there's nothing wrong with a man pampering his woman, but when they say these are their main characteristics, like their main qualifications, is they can cook, clean, you know, and they can fix you dinner when you come home, and they can run a bubble bath. It's like, okay, is there anything else you can do? A lot of black men try to overdo being masculine, you know. So this is a problem, I believe, too, within our communities. A lot of our men try to overdo being masculine in the wrong ways, and a lot of ways come off as abusive and controlling. So a lot of ways that black men need to come off as masculine, protective, of their women, you know, not calling their women names, not being so easy to disrespect their women verbally, but they try to overdo being masculine in ways that are unnecessary, and are not useful to the black woman. They a lot of times they'll try to brag about how many women they can sleep with at one time, how many women they can get pregnant with no plan of being a father to any of them. A lot of them try to be physically violent and verbally aggressive to black women, because I believe there's an imbalance in black men, a lot of our black men knowing how to be men. So I don't know how to be a man. Excuse me, I'm not a man, but I think neither do a lot of young black men. They're missing that component from elderly black men on how to be black men. So they're trying to overdo it. It's almost like, you know, no pun intended, but it's almost like a gay guy trying to be a woman, and he's overdoing it. And I think a lot of black men, you know, they're trying to be men, but they're trying to overdo it in the wrong ways. So I do have a couple questions, okay, for the black man. You know, how can black women learn to respect black men if every time we raise a question to an issue, the black man becomes, the black man blames a white man. So I'm going to repeat that. How can black women learn to respect black men if every time we raise a question to an issue, the black man blames the white man? You know, I've been talking to, you know, I talked to a brother at one time and I'll ask them, you know, how come the black man doesn't stay in the house? How come the black man, you know, likes to play games, and how come he likes to sleep with multiple women and he doesn't like to take care of his responsibilities? And once that woman becomes pregnant, he's out the door and he's mad because she's upset and trying to put him on child support. So he's running from his responsibilities. You know, a black man told me, he said, because we were raised by the white man to do so. And I'm like, you know, that's another thing. How can the black man ever get any respect from this world or his woman, if when he's backed into a corner with his back pressed against the wall as a man, that you continue to blame other people other than yourself? And you want to be considered a man, though, okay? The lead and the head. So that's my first question. How can we as black women learn to trust black men when black men don't even trust each other, okay? So how can we as black women trust black men? Okay, because that's one thing that men always say that they want from their women is trust. But black men don't even trust each other. Y'all killing each other. Y'all hurting each other. So we're supposed to trust you and you guys can't even trust each other. How can black women and children look up to you as the pillars of the community when you lack respect for yourselves? When will black men stop blaming black women for all of their problems and realize the part they have played? You know, like I said, in all these videos, you'll hear about the black woman did this, my black mother did this, the black woman did this. You know, like I said, anytime a black child ends up killed or murdered by the mother's boyfriend, but where was that black father at? Okay, because if that black father was in the household like he was supposed to be, not across the street, not living across town, then what man can come in and kill your child? You know, a lot of these black men, they want to cry once the child is deceased by the boyfriend or some other stranger or the child's mother, but they're not crying when that mother or that child is born and they decide to walk up out the house for the fathers that do leave the house. Okay, so, you know, there, you know, a lot of this blame shifting, it just needs to be equal balance. It's time for the black man to look at himself in the mirror. If he wants to be taken seriously, that he's head over anything, then he, you know, like I said, because I don't know too many men that, you know, consider themselves true men and leadership and leadership positions, and they're blaming everybody but themselves as the leader. Okay, how can a man ever be taken seriously if he cannot stand on his own two feet and take responsibility for what is his? And that pretty much wraps up this segment. Look, I love all the brothers out there. I love all the sisters out there. It's been a pleasure talking with you all. If you'd like to get in contact with me, if you have any questions or suggestions, you can reach me at thetruthwithtrinity.com. You can also listen to my podcast on YouTube, Spotify, and Anchor. And always remember, if you can't tell the truth with anyone else, you can with Trinity. Till next time, take care.